Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. This is me, Mrs. Sheetal Jane Pillay, presenting to you All the World's a Stage, written by William Shakespeare, which is an adaptation of his play As You Like It. This poem deals about two stages, which is sadness and realization. This poem talks about seven stages of man, and particularly the second last and the last stages of man. You realize that life is nothing but merely a play. All you need to do is take birth and leave. After performing all your duties, why run after fame, name and money? Why do you want to have everything in life when you absolutely have to leave with nothing? Personally, I feel that this poem also talks about the roles of other people in your life. Just like you are playing a part, so are they. People in your life enter to teach you something new and leave, gifting you a bunch of memories to dwell on. So stay tuned with me while I present All the World's a Stage, written by William Shakespeare. William Shakespeare, born in the year 1564 and died in 1616, was an English poet, playwright, and actor. Widely regarded as the greatest writer in the English language and the world's prominent dramatist, he is often called England's national poet and the Bard of Avon. This poem is taken from his play As You Like It. Here he compares the world to a stage where the drama of human life is enacted. Question number one, warming up. Talk to your friend about all the things related to seven. For example, seven wonders of the world, the seven continents, that is North America, South America, Africa, Europe, Asia, seven seas of the world, that is Arctic Ocean, Antarctic Ocean, North Atlantic Ocean, South Atlantic, Indian Ocean, North Pacific Ocean and South Pacific Ocean. So you need to fill in this into your textbook according to the question given. Question 2. Life is often compared to many things. Write down 7 things that life can be compared to and justify the comparison. For example, life is a keyboard because if you press the right keys, you have typed a good destiny. So these are basically quotes on life, which are often compared to many things. The second one, life is like a river that is always flowing. Life is like a seed. It will never grow unless planted, nourished, and nurtured. So you can find n number of quotes on the internet, and you can complete the same in your textbook. Question number 3, match the approximate age with the stages. The first one, birth to 2 years is babyhood, 3 years to 12 years is childhood, 13 to 17 is teenage or adolescence, 18 years to 44 years is adulthood, 45 to 60 is middle age, 65 years to 75 or 80 is a senior citizen or an elderly person. Above 80 is old age or the second childhood. So they say when you become old, you start reliving or acting like a child, and that is why it is called as your second childhood. This poem is taken from the play written by William Shakespeare called As You Like It, and this poem is a monologue which is recited by Jack while playing a character in the play. The poem talks about the world being a stage, which means life is compared to a stage where human beings are compared to players or actors, where life and death is compared to the entry and exits of a play. And the poem talks about every man who has their own role to play in the world. There are 7 stages mentioned in the poem, and each stage have their uniqueness and a peculiar quality in them, making them different from each other. While I read the poem, I request all the students to open their textbooks and underline the various stages of man and understand the importance of the stages of man as mentioned in the poem. The poet says the whole world is a stage and all the men and women in it are merely actors. They have their exits and entrance, that is, they are born and they will die. A man plays many different parts during his lifetime, each actor playing 7 roles during his lifetime. The first role is that of an infant, where the minute the infant is born, he starts crying weakly and starts throwing up in his nurse's arms. So there is nothing much that the infant can do except mewling and puking, which means crying and puking in the nurse's arm. The second stage is that of a schoolboy who complains and cries. He goes to school early in the morning with a well-scrubbed, shining face. So he is excited to go to school. However, that excitement dies down as he proceeds to school. He carries his school bag and creeps down like a snail and proceeds unwillingly to school. The third is that of a lover who is breathless and sighing like a furnace. So he has so much passion and so much love for his lover that he burns with passion, and that is why sighing with furnace is he has that kind of passion and he's burning with woeful ballad. Woeful ballad means sad songs. He sings sad songs and he dedicates that to the beauty of his lover. The fourth stage is that of a soldier who is aggressive and who takes a lot of oaths. He's bearded like a leopard. He's jealous where his honor is concerned and is quick to quarrel. He's also ambitious and does a lot of things to protect his reputation, even if it is endangering his life. The fifth role is that of a matured middleman. The matured middleman is with a round belly developed after eating a lot of chickens that he received in return of favors done. He is stern and formal and full of wisdom. He is keen on justice. He is full of wise sayings and gives modern examples. In the sixth stage, man has become old. With thin legs in slippers and loose pants, he has spectacles on his nose and a pouch by his side. The close-fitting stockings which he had saved from his younger days are now too big for his thin legs, which have shrunk with age. His loud voice, which was once manly, has now become childish and shrill. There are whistling sounds when he talks. The last stage of all is the end of eventful life. It is when man becomes senile and enters the second childhood. He is unaware of what is happening around him. This final stage is when he is without teeth, without vision, without taste and without anything, which means basically he loses hope and only awaits death to embrace him. So all the world's a stage and all the men and women merely players. They have their exits and entrance. Exits and entrance refers to life and death of a person. And one man in his time plays many parts, his acts being 7 ages, 7 stages of life. At first, the infant, mewling and puking in the nurse's arms. Then the whining schoolboy with his satchel and shining morning face, creeping like snail, unwillingly to school. And then the lover, sighing like furnace with a woeful ballad, sad songs, made to his mistress eyebrow. Then a soldier, full of strange oaths and bearded like the pard. Pard means a leopard. Jealous in honor, sudden and quick in quarrel, seeking the bubble reputation, even in the cannon's mouth. Cannon's mouth means life full of dangers. And then the justice, which means the middle-aged man, in fair round belly with good cap and lined, with eyes serve and beard of formal cut, full of wise saws and modern instances, and so he plays his part. The sixth age shifts into the lean and slippered pantaloon, with spectacles on nose and pouch on side, his youthful horse well saved, a world too wide, for his shrunk shank and his big manly voice, turning again towards childish treble pipes, and whistle in his sound, last scenes of all, that ends this strange eventful history. In second childishness and mere oblivion, oblivion means unaware of the surrounding, sans teeth, sans eyes, sans taste, sans everything. So, no teeth, no eyes, no taste. So basically he's awaiting death. And the major difference between the fifth and the sixth stage is, in the fifth stage, the man is old, but yes, he knows his surrounding, he can learn his surrounding, he's wise, he's adviceful, whereas in the sixth stage, the man has become old and he's unaware, he's oblivion of his surrounding, unaware of anything that is going around him, and becomes like a child who needs help at every stage of his life. So this poem has a lot of images, imagery, where each stage is so beautifully explained, and you can actually imagine everything that is written just like a movie running in front of your eyes. There are seven stages referred to seven ages of man, right from the infant to the old age. And in the poem, Shakespeare has compared life with a stage. He has used different words to beautifully express the poem in a wonderful way. He has taken this concept from a medieval philosophy and showed glimpses of different groups as the seven deadly sins of theological reasons. Theology is the study of God's nature as well as religious belief. So this poem is compared to philosophy, and that is called as theology, which means study of the nature made by God. The poem All the World's a Stage, written by Shakespeare, creates a somber mood and a fact tone where the speaker knows that this is the way around the world. We are all going to end up back where we started as a child, and there is no way to change it. That is why all facts are mentioned in the poem. Read the words in the given cloud and match them to what they signify. Stages signifies life. Characters are roles played by human beings. Script means story of life. Dialogues is a conversation that two human beings have. Your entry is the birth, and your exits is the death that takes place, as mentioned in the poem. Carefully and complete the following. There are seven stages, as mentioned in the poem. What are the role of the seven stages and what are the qualities as mentioned in the poem has to be done in question number 2 of the English workshop. The first being infant, where the infant is frightened, crying and puking. Second is the schoolboy who is unhappy and whining to go to school. Third is that of a lover who is woeful and sighing, singing sad ballads, sad songs. Fourth is that of a soldier who's jealous in honor, who's ambitious, who's quarreling without any reason, and who faces danger. Fifth is the adult man who's fat, serious and wise, and always loves giving advices. Then is that middle-aged man who's thin and shrunken, talking in a shrill voice. Next is a very old man who's childlike, oblivion of his surrounding, and who is waiting to embrace death delightfully. The difference between the following stages of a man's life as explained in the poem. The second stage basically deals with a schoolboy who is complaining and crying, who goes to school but who's unhappy to go to school, and that is why he proceeds to school like a snail, carrying his bag and creeps slowly. However, the fourth stage is that of an aggressive soldier who's ready to do anything for his honor and who is very ambitious. Unlike the schoolboy, the soldier is very ambitious and does useless things for his reputation. Even for the matter of fact, when it comes to endangering his life, he will not step backward. Next, the third and fifth stage, as based on the poem, is the third stage is that of a lover who is breathless and who sings with passion, and he sings sad songs and dedicates that to his beauty of his love. The fifth stage is that of a middle-aged man who has surpassed that phase of a lover, and now he is stern and formal and full of wisdom, and who loves giving advices and sings with modern examples. The first and the last stage, the first stage is that of an infant crying. He is unaware of what is happening around him. The first stage is that of a baby who begins his life, who has no teeth, no vision, without taste, and has nothing around him, and who is oblivion. The last stage also is one where a man becomes senile and enters in his second childhood. He is again unaware of what is happening around him, but this is the final stage where he also has no teeth, no vision, no taste, and is without anything. So basically, the first and the last stage, the qualities of the stages are different. However, the first is the beginning and the last is the end of an eventful life. Pick out the lines that contain imagery, a picture created in the mind by using words of the following people. So imagery is a picture already created. If I say a red beautiful rose, you can think of that beautiful rose as an image in your mind, and that is called as imagery. So when I say schoolboy, the schoolboy was whining, he was carrying his bag, his face was shining, and he was walking like a snail. A soldier, he was taking strange oath, he was bearded like a leopard, he was jealous in honor, and he was quick in quarrel. The fifth stage, that of a wise man or a judge, he was fat, he had a round belly, and he had a formal cut with a beard. The sixth stage, that of a senior citizen, was that of a youthful horse, well saved, and had shrunken socks or shoes because he had thin legs. The difference between free verse and blank verse, poem 1.1, Where the Mind is Without Fear by Tagore, is an example of free verse where there was no rhyming words and there was no rhythm in the poem. However, the current poem written by Shakespeare is called a blank verse because there is no rhyming words. However, the poem has a rhythm and it is a ununiformity in the rhythm, and that is why it is called as a blank verse. So the free verse has no regular pattern of stressed or unstressed syllable, whereas the blank verse has a regular pattern of stressed or unstressed syllable and followed by a stressed one. For example, if you can see in the following lines, the stressed syllable, which means where when you speak and all the men and women are merely players, you can see that A is stressed in all, men is stressed, and that is why it is called as a stress syllable, which is an example of a blank verse. The uniqueness of this poem is that the entire poem is metaphorical, which means it is compared. There is an implied comparison. For example, the world is compared to stage, actor is compared to players or human beings, birth and death are compared to entrances and exits, schoolboy, a snail, a lover's sigh is like a furnace, spotted leopard is a bearded soldier, and the last stage is actually the last scene of life. Pick out two examples, out of which one will be done and one will have to be done by the students. Simile, soldier's beard like the pard, which means the leopard is indirectly compared to the soldier by using the word like. Second, onomatopoeia, sighing like a furnace. The sound sighing is compared indirectly to the furnace, and onomatopoeia has a sound expression in sighing. Alliteration, they have their exits and their entrance. E in exits and entrance have been repeated. Metaphor, which is an implied comparison, they have their exits and their entrance, which means exits and entrance are compared to life and death. Inversion, his acts being seven ages. Transferred epithet, wherein an adjective is transferred from a human to a being, for example, with woeful ballad. So your ballad is expressed as woeful, however, the lover is woeful, is sad for his girlfriend, and that is why this is an example of transferred epithet, wherein an adjective is transferred from a human being to an object. Read the summary of the play As You Like It, written by William Shakespeare, and we need to find out the character that narrated the poem and on what occasion. Make a list of all the characters on the play. So as already discussed, the character who narrated the poem is called as Jax, and he narrates this in Act 2 in Scene 7. Some of the other characters in the play are Celia, Rosalind, Orlando, Oliver, Duke Senior, Duke Frederick, and Touchstone. As You Like It is a play in your 12th standard textbook, so you can learn more about it once you reach the 12th. And the second assignment is read the poem again and write an appreciation of the poem in a paragraph format. You need to refer to the previous paragraph appreciation that was taught. Thank you, everyone. You can post your doubts in the comment section and I'll be happy to answer. Till then, stay tuned to my channel and stay safe. Bye-bye.